Hello, my name is Gabriele Elia Cazzato, and I'm going to talk about my role in the extracurricular project Realize for the Computer Architecture course held at Politecnico di Torino by professors Paolo Montuschi and Lucas Darpone, in the context of the Computer Engineering Bachelor Program. The development board available to my team, the DigiLenzivo, is rich in peripherals and features a complex system on chip, the Xilinx Zynq Z7010, which integrates Xilinx 7 series field programmable gate array logic with a processing system built around a dual-core ARM Cortex-A9 processor. While the main focus of the project was programming the FPGA to realize a simple video game, it seemed appropriate to put this processing system to work, using it without the support of an operating system as a bridge between various hardware on the board, specifically the Zynq's programmable logic, the microsecure digital slot, and the double data rate 3 random access memory. For testing purposes, the USB UART bridge, as well as basic input-output hardware, LEDs and switches, were also involved in my design. One of my goals was configuring a microSD card from which the Zynq could boot and transfer at startup into the DDR the game's maps and sprites. This separation between data and logic makes the game easily moddable, allowing to alter its appearance and dynamics by just replacing a couple of files on the SD, and thus without having to resynthesize code, which can be a lengthy operation. On the programmable logic side, I designed an advanced extensible interface Nasser peripheral, which can be queried at runtime by the actual game modules to access DDR data. Having to coordinate processing system and programmable logic operations, I was also in charge of putting together the top block design in Xilinx Vivado Design Suite. From the games and the AXI Master source files, I created and parameterized two separate intellectual property cores, which were properly wired to each other and to the processing system core. The AXI Master is connected through a dedicated interconnect core to one of the high-performance AXI ports of the processing system, which in turn accesses the DDR via its DRAM controller. The game can request data by sending the AXI Master an enable signal, together with a 1-bit data type signal and an 8-bit data ID signal. If data type is 0, the map whose index is specified by data ID is requested. If data type is 1, all sprites are requested regardless of data ID. Data is received by the game in 32-bit packets and is stored in two separate programmable logic block RAMs for fast runtime access. A signal indicating whether a transfer is taking place is also received. Our design uses three different clocks: a 25 MHz clock for the video graphics array, a 100 MHz clock for the sprites block RAM, and a main 50 MHz clock used by all other modules. To synchronize processing system and programmable logic, these clocks are all generated from the processing system's phase-locked loop through a dedicated clock generator core. The AXI Master signals and registers are resettable whenever the processing system is reset, for example at power on, or when pressing the system reset button on the Zeebo, it sends a signal to a dedicated reset handler core, which then forwards it to the AXI Master and to the interconnect as well. A binary boot file is packaged in Xilinx SDK containing the Zynq's first stage bootloader, the FPGA programming bitstream, and the standalone C program with instructions to perform the SD to DDR transfer. This file is placed on a FAT32 formatted microSD card together with the maps and sprites binary files. The C program uses the FATFS library to mount the card's file system, to open in sequence the two binary files, and copy their content to two separate addresses in a range which is specifically reserved for the DDR and is accessible both by the CPU and the programmable logic. Printed debug messages can be displayed on a PC connected to the board's serial port. With the microSD card inserted in the slot and the programming mode jumper set to SD, the board is turned on. And as a last step of the boot sequence, the SD to DDR transfer is performed. The game queries the Exe Master through an internal initialization model, which was written together with other team members in VHDL. This module requests at the beginning of the game all sprites and one random map. Another random map is requested whenever a new game level is reached. The purpose of the Exe Master is to act as a simple, read-only interface of the DDR for the game, which doesn't need to understand the details of a full Exe 4 burst read transaction. The module is parameterized using the number of maps and sprites, their sizes, and their base DDR addresses, making it easily adaptable to different situations. The Exe Master is composed by a controller and an actuator. The actuator was built using the source code of Xilinx Exe Master Burst Core, which helps to make Exe signals slightly more manageable. The controller, which was written in System Verilog, acts as an interpreter between the game and the actuator. When it is enabled by the game, it sends the actuator a request signal, together with a length and an address, which depend on whether the game has requested one map or all sprites. The controller then waits for a command acknowledged signal from the actuator, upon which the request, length and address are reset. A source ready signal from the actuator is forwarded to the game, indicating it can start reading packets from the data channel. At the end of the transaction, the actuator sends the controller a complete signal and the controller becomes idle. The controller sends other signals to the actuator for this transaction to happen as intended, but they can be kept constant the whole time. I hope this video can be of help for people approaching embedded systems, FPGAs and the Zynq in particular, and Exe technology for the first time. And of course, I thank you all for watching. Goodbye.